of introducing to you Kirk Overall, a TV and movie star. So give a big yell and
I am not a movie star, I'm a television personality, but thank you. Okay, guys. I'm going to run for U.S. Senate, by golly. And for those of you who just remember me as an actress, can everybody hear me now?
Yes!
We're okay? All right, I'll talk right into it. I was an actress. I was very successful. I loved it. I was in luck. And I had the fortune or misfortune to meet a very famous gumshoe novelist. Very serious man. What he does is he represents abused children. And in order to represent the children, he has to write books to be able to afford to represent them because children have no money. So he says to me, Kirk, what you do is not real. And I knew for me it was true. And I decided to come back to Tennessee to do something meaningful with my life. I've always wanted to. I'm going to try to do it. Now you invited me here, so I'm on the top to you because I tell it like it is. Our world as women was paved a long time ago by great minds like Betty Friedan, even as far back as George Sand. And somewhere along the line, the last 30 to 50 years, your elected officials pulled the rug out from under us, and they took charge of your womanhood. And as mother always says, they is the biggest fools in the world. Now the scared white men are running this country, pulled the rug out from under us. We fought for women, we fought for our freedoms, and we fought. We won that stuff a long time ago. Across the country to circumvent law and destroy all the decades of progress we fought for. Yeah. I am so tickled to see so many people here, and I am loving this sign. Yeah. Now let's take a look for a minute at Wisconsin. Let's look at Scott Walker. Yeah. Mr. Popularity. About a week ago, in the middle of the night, he took away equal pay for women, just like that. And the death of Trayvon Martin, I think, is going to mean something historically. And the American Legislative Exchange Council, Alex. Well, now Coca-Cola's pulled out. Trayvon's parents realize what a turning point this is. So far, they seem to understand it really well. I'm really proud of them.
Yeah.
And we are waking up to the insanity of our Congress and to our corporations. And let me give you some quotes here. These are my personal favorites about what's happened up here on the Tennessee Hill. Stomp transgenders into mud holes. Slowly. I think that's excessive to stomp them. I just find that excessive. Don't say gay in the scoop. Where are those little children supposed to go to find themselves? And who are they supposed to talk to? Yeah. turns to the classroom, and this Matthew Hill up from my way says, you must have hospital privileges to perform an abortion.
Use our voice.
basis now. Even in the French Revolution, George Sand, bless her heart, started her own newspaper in the name of a cooperative, and she wrote, "I cannot believe in any republic that starts a revolution by killing its own proletariat." It's happening here, and it's happening there. Joe Biden wrote the Violence Against Women Act in 1994. It offers legal protection to women who are victims of domestic violence. So what's the problem? Well, it was extended to protect women in same-sex marriages, Native American women, and illegal immigrant women. Hear me now. All eight members of the state judiciary committee blocked it. So that means that it's wrong to beat up most women, but if you're gay, Indian, or undocumented, you're fair game. It's open season. Bob Corker voted for the Blunt Amendment. Anybody help me with this one. Why was our womb attached to a transportation bill? Why was my womb attached to a transportation bill? And everybody says, "Well, Park, that's just the way it's done." Well, you know what? It ain't good enough.
Now it's right!
I don't want to come out sounding like a man-hating mouthpiece. I just grew up with the Betty Friedan set. That kind of thing. And it's hard for me to see a backslide. I don't know what this is. It's gotta stop. Betty Friedan gives me half a heart right now towards Congress. She said, "Men weren't really the enemy. They were fellow victims suffering from an outmoded masculine mystique that made them feel unnecessarily inadequate when there were not bears to kill." I am running for the United States Senate because I am outraged. And I'm going to do whatever I can, even if I just stir that political pot, I'm on top. It's not just about the war on the environment, y'all. It's also about the war on women, the war on the environment. And so, if you knew what your government was not doing in cases of brutal, horrible child abuse, I could bring you all to the end. Our government ain't focused on the right issues. I'm going to leave you with the wisdom of Molly Island. There is far too much unthinking respect given to authority. What you need is sustained outrage.